The modern periodic table is a cornerstone of chemistry, offering a systematic arrangement of all known chemical elements based on their fundamental properties. This ingenious framework provides invaluable insights into the behavior and characteristics of elements, facilitating scientific understanding and breakthroughs. Its development was a gradual process, culminating in the elegant table we know today. At the heart of the periodic table lies the concept of atomic number. This unique identifier represents the number of protons in an atom's nucleus and defines an element's chemical identity. Dmitri Mendeleev, a Russian chemist, is often credited with the initial organization of elements in the late 19th century. Mendeleev noticed that when elements were arranged by increasing atomic mass, patterns emerged in their properties and reactivity. He arranged the elements into rows and columns, leaving gaps for undiscovered elements yet to be identified. This allowed him to predict the properties of these missing elements. The modern periodic table, however, arranges elements based on increasing atomic number. This change resolves some inconsistencies that arose when ordering elements by atomic mass, as protons determine an element's atomic number. Ranging elements by this factor yields a more logical sequence. This shift in approach led to the formulation of the law of periodic table, which states that the physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic functions of their atomic numbers. The table structure consists of periods and groups. Periods are horizontal rows and groups are vertical columns. There are 7 periods and 18 groups in the modern periodic table. Each element in a period has one more proton and one more electron than the element preceding it, resulting in a gradual increase in atomic number and mass as you move from left to right across a period. Groups, on the other hand, are characterized by similar outer electron configurations. Elements within the same group share comparable chemical properties due to these shared electron configurations. This arrangement facilitates the prediction of an element's reactivity, valency, and other characteristics based on its group placement. The periodic table is divided into several blocks based on the type of atomic orbital being filled by electrons. 1. S block of the first two groups, hydrogen and helium, are exceptions, belong to the S block. Elements in this block have their outermost electrons in the S orbital. 2. P block, groups 13 to 18 make up the P block. Elements in this block have their outermost electrons in the P orbital. 3. D block, groups 3 to 12 constitute the D block. Transition metals primarily fill this block with their outermost electrons in the D orbital. 4. F block, this block is further split into the lanthanides and actinides series. Lanthanides of 57, 71 and actinides 89, 103 have their outermost electrons in the F orbital. The periodic table's organization allows scientists to discern periodic trends, gradual variations in properties across periods and groups. Some of these trends include atomic radius, size of atoms, ionization energy, energy required to remove an electron, and electron affinity, ability to attract an electron, and electronegativity, ability to attract electrons in a chemical bond. For instance, atomic radius generally decreases across a period and increases down a group, while ionization energy generally increases across a period and decreases down a group. The periodic table also provides insights into the properties of transition elements, rare earth elements, and noble gases. Transition elements are known for their variable oxidation states and their involvement in catalysis. Rare earth elements belong into the F block, have unique magnetic and luminescent properties. Noble gases occupy in group 18 are chemically inert due to their stable electron configurations. Furthermore, the periodic table aids in predicting and understanding element behavior and chemical reactions. Elements on the left side of the table, the groups 1 and 2, tend to lose electrons and form positive ions and cations, while those on the right, groups 16 and 17, tend to gain electrons and form negative ions and anions. In summary, the modern periodic table is a systematic arrangement of elements that encapsulates their properties, reactivity, and behaviors. This remarkable tool has revolutionized the field of chemistry by providing a structured framework for understanding the building blocks of matter. Its legacy continues to guide scientists in exploring new elements, predicting their characteristics, and unraveling the complexities of the natural world.